Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Dowson Ness from MimicMethod.com, and I'm right now with Brian and John Tubin, twin brothers who are competing to learn Spanish before their 30th birthday. What inspired you guys to take on this challenge?
Learning Spanish is something that I've always wanted to do. You know, coming up on our 30th birthday, it's a milestone birthday, and felt like it would be a cool way to kind of celebrate it. People say, oh, if you don't learn a language before the age of 20, you'll never learn another language. It's really hard. So it's like, screw that. Let's do it.
How did you rope your brother into this?
So it was kind of a call. What was it, last week or the other week ago? He said, hey, John. So I was talking to my buddy and I have this crazy idea and I want to know if you're into it. I pretty much said yes right away. Like right after he was done talking, I'm like, hell yeah, let's do it. There's been so many times that I've said to Brian, you know, oh, this is a great idea, let's do this, and it never really comes to fruition. So the fact that he brought it to the table, I was like, you know what, let's go.
As someone with a lot of experience helping people learn foreign language, the biggest challenge I find is the motivation. I know sibling rivalry and competition is a really huge motivating factor. What are some things that you've competed on the past?
Sports, just like our whole life, basketball, baseball, football. I mean, when we were younger, we were different size, but we were always very competitive. Like, I was actually like this fat kid, and he was like super skinny. That being said, we still would do like foot races, and like we were still like similarly athletic. And then in high school, we were similar size, similar ability, same genetic makeup. When we would play basketball, it's like, oh, you're gonna guard your brother. And it's like, you're guarding yourself. And it's like, shit, like, I know exactly what he's going to do. He knows exactly what I'm going to do. So it's like, it's really just who's more competitive that day that's going to win. Except me, because I'm better, so I'm going to win. But
yeah. It's beyond sports. He challenges himself, so it makes me challenge myself. He's done things academically and from a job perspective and just general the way he lives his life that is a cause to emulate. But it's really using him and having a twin brother to challenge myself.
In other ways, it's not a competition. It's about mutual growth. And there is this aspect of being twins where like we are different people, but there's that natural connection that happens. And so what he's doing in his life and what I'm doing in my life, there's always a healthy growth in comparison. At least our relationship is like that.
And I remember when I first met you, you felt that being a monolingual English speaker in a modern society, especially in the U.S., you feel handicapped. Can you tell us a bit about how you felt this handicap in your day-to-day life, maybe a specific experience or anecdote where not knowing Spanish or another language has held you back?
For me, there's very visceral, tangible examples every day of this. I run a food business, so in that industry, there's a lot of native Spanish speakers. And on a daily basis, I'm in my kitchen and I'm interacting with kitchen staff and I'm interacting with, you know, there's a guy who is building a cafe in the front of my kitchen and he is a native Spanish speaker. And like we interact, but, you know, there's opportunities to connect deeper. I'll say stuff like, you know, hola, ¿qué pasa? And like, that's the extent of it, you know, and like, I wish I could kind of like, you know, interact a little bit more. And yeah, just like knowing a lot of my American native English speaker friends, seems like all of them know at least one other language. And a lot of them is Spanish. So I'm sitting here and I'm like, okay, I'm 29. I'm an educated person. I took Spanish in high school, but like, that's it. And I feel like I'm behind.
But let's not get it twisted. Brian's doing it for the ladies. Come on. You're doing it for the ladies. Let's be real about this. That's why you're taking those salsa classes. No, but I completely agree with Brian. I mean, I wouldn't say that I felt it as a handicap, but I can relate to that sentiment for sure. I live in New York City and, you know, there's bodegas on every corner. There is, you know, a local Mexican restaurant that I go to that's literally a hole in the wall. And it's a husband and wife and they run the place. And I try to talk Spanish to them. I'm like, oh, pollo con arroz, buenas noches. And then, you know, I can't really get further than that. And it would be cool to have this relationship with him if I was able to talk about how his day was or how his business was in his native tongue. So that would be awesome. Also, I play rugby and a lot of my teammates, they're native Spanish speakers and they have a kinship with each other that's, you know, maybe a little different than I do with them. It's kind of unique and different. It's cool to see the interaction that they have and whether it's on the field, off the field. So that's another aspect. And also for me, a big reason is there's this idea of giving back to the local community. And a lot of the youth and the young kids, you know, are Spanish speakers. So as they start to, you know, interact with them, whether it's coaching rugby or being a mentor, that just adds another element to who I'd be able to touch and reach out to.
Final question for you guys is, who's going to win?
Right here.
So I want to say, like, of course I'm going to win, but honestly, it's kind of like, we'll both win. Like, we're going to do this, you know what I mean?
I mean, I can tell you, I'm going to give him a run for his money. I'm going to make sure that he's staying honest, and we're going to work. We're going to do this, but I'm going to actually win, though. Like, I'm going to be the winner, but we're doing it. We're both winning, so.
If you're watching, stay tuned for more videos. We're going to keep releasing progress, showing Brian and John actually doing our program to learn speaking to real people in Spanish and whatnot. And so stay tuned. Subscribe to our channel if you want to follow along with that progress. I'll see you next week after the first mission.
All right, sounds good, man.
Yeah, see you guys.
Casar.
Sabe.
Plazoleta.
Plazoleta.
Nueva.
Cena.
Uvo.
Cena.
Habla.
Voz.
Estaba.
Voz.
Selva.
Cima.
Lobo.
Cima.